everybody, it's your favorite Auntie Mo, and we are back for another episode review of Power. This is season 6, episode 4, Why is Tommy Still Alive? Before we get into the review, if you have not done so just yet, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Like, you watching my videos anyway, go and subscribe. Let me know what you think of this video with a thumbs up or a thumbs down, and then hit that notification bell so you will know whenever I upload new content. Also want to remind you guys to shop Andrea's clothing. Use coupon code AUNTIEMO15 and you will receive 15% off your purchase. Also want to remind you guys as well about Run It Up. That's my Kim Focus playing in the background. Go to SoundCloud right now and check that out. Y'all already know, Auntie's sipping on Moscato, and you already know Moscato give me hot on. I'm finna give y'all a good ass review. I got my mango strawberry ready. Tonight's episode was good. Of course, I got Stars app, so lucky for y'all, you get the review a little bit early, you know what I'm saying? So if you ain't watched it yet, you don't wanna know what happened, go and click off, because this is a spoiler. Just saying. But hopefully y'all are ready for the review, because I'm ready to give it to you, so let's get right on up into it. All right, y'all, so I knew Angela wasn't going to be away for too long. Her ghost is sitting up here haunting ghosts. He all up feeling sad and guilty about his life and shit. Her ghost just pop up out of nowhere, basically like, why is it that you always chose the life over me? You always chose Tommy over me. Then she asked him, like, why is Tommy still alive? And he's like, I don't know. I tried to do this. I tried to do that. Just then, his phone rings, and it's Jason, Serbian dude, calling him like, look here, motherfucker, it's payday. What's good? You know, he want his money, because his little deal was on the last episode, if you deliver me Alicia Jimenez, then I'll get off your back about this 10K every 2 weeks that you owe me. So since you didn't bring Alicia, Tommy bought him first, you owe me 10K plus a little interest off of her. So Ghost is caught up in a doggone pickle right now. He getting haunted by Angela's ghost, plus you got Tommy trying to kill you. Now you got Serbian dude Jason all up down in your pockets. He don't know what the hell to do. Meanwhile, Tommy meeting with the hood dudes. He's telling them that finally he got a big shipment that's coming in that night, that he's getting it from the Serbian dudes or whatever. So he's telling them, like, look, I need y'all to be on high alert, because when it goes down and I make the call, I need y'all to be ready. Just then, his phone keep ringing, blowing up. And his homeboys is like, don't nobody blow up your phone like that but your mama or your girl. Come to find out, it was Keisha calling about his mama. He goes to the house. His mama is there, because his mama says something about her apartment is being fumigated, so she has to be out for 2 days. Now she's staying at the house with Tommy while her apartment is being fumigated. Also, Keisha is there, his new little girlfriend or whatever, right? We already know how Keisha, we gonna get on Keisha in a little bit or whatever, right? So right before, now Tommy tells, you know, mama, it's okay that you stay in here because I'm gonna be gone for the night anyway. Now mind you, again, he has that shipment that he has to go pick up from the Serbians. Now Keisha looking like, you wrong as hell. Why you just gonna leave me here with your mama? I don't even damn know your mama. Barely know your ass. You just gonna leave me here at the house with your mama? Like, really? Like, damn. But you know, she trying to be a hustler's wife anyway, so she trying to be down. So she gonna stay there at the house with the mama. Now, before Tommy leaves, he tells Keisha, go on, pack me up a piece of that pie that you make, because you know you make that pie oh so well. Tommy mama gonna say to Keisha, I'm so glad that you cooked, because that last girl of his he had didn't cook worth of nothing. You remember Holly? Yeah, they had a bad breakup. Keisha kind of looking like, what the hell is you talking about? Now mama, why you even bring that up in the first place? Ain't nobody even said nothing about Holly. But you know how mamas are, because I'm sure I'm gonna be that kind of mama too. I'm just saying. But Keisha was looking like, what the hell is she talking about? What the hell happened with Holly? Sax with his old crooked ass, he ends up meeting up with Lindsay. Now, Lindsay, as we remember, that is the ex of Proctor. He's got that little recording device on her backpack, the little unicorn, that's recording everything that happens, because he's trying to get Proctor caught up in something, right? So she's meeting up with Sax. They're listening to the recordings, and basically all they hear on the recordings is Lindsay smacking a little girl, Elisa Marie, around. So Sax is telling her, look here, I don't have nothing to go off of. All I've been hearing is hours and hours of you being a badass mom. If you can't give me nothing to go off on that I can use to prosecute Ghost for this murder, then, you know, all the jury, I mean, basically all the courts is gonna get is how you a badass mama. So she was like, well, Elisa Marie told me that some scary white guy with blonde hair named Tommy came to the house. Is that something that you can use? And of course, Sax with his crooked ass, he's like, yeah, okay, that could be something I could use against him. Because mind you, again, on this recording, he nothing. It's just hours and hours of her being a badass mama. So he like, oh, okay, let me see if I can use this to try to flip this some kind of way. All right, y'all, so Ghost is at the club. He on the phone making business deals, whoop-de-whoop. Next thing you know, Proctor comes in the room. He brings in Dre. Ghost lost it. He damn near killed this fool with a writing pen. He like, how dare you bring this fool up in my club? I should kill him. I can't trust him. He crooked, which we all know. Baby, Dre got to go. Dre got to go, especially at the end of this episode. So he like, look here, it's the new U.S. attorney that wants to go ahead with the RICO case against you and against me and against Tasha and against everybody. So Dre has some information that we need to listen to. He can probably help us out on this case. Now Ghost is like, if you got something to say, you better say something quick because I'm about to kill your goddamn ass. Now, Dre tells Ghost that Miguel Alvarez, his girlfriend, is the witness that they have that's going to testify against them. He also tells them that Sax wants to use him to take Ghost down as the killer for Angela's murder and basically like the head behind everything that's going on. Now, Ghost doesn't trust Dre worth a damn, but Proctor is like, we can use Dre so that the FBI can think that he's working for us, but actually he'll be getting us information so that we know whenever the FBI is trying to come after us. Now, we already know Dre is somebody that cannot be trusted worth a damn, and Ghost knows that. Ghost is like, what in the hell would make you think that I would trust you for any damn thing? You crooked as hell. Dre tells him the FBI has my daughter, so of course you gotta trust me because I gotta trust y'all because they got my damn daughter. So he like, look here, you need to wear a wire. I need you to go back to Sax, tell Sax that I'm clean, I ain't got nothing to do with this. In the meantime, in between time, Proctor, I need you to check it out, see if the FBI really has his daughter. Once we confirm everything, you do everything you're supposed to do, then I'll let you know if we can work with you. But as of right now, nigga, I don't trust you. And y'all already know, baby, Dre got to go. Hashtag, if y'all agree with me, put that down in the comments. Trey got to go. Dre got to go. Tasha calls the divorce lawyer and tells her that she wants to put things on hold with the divorce for right now. Now, as you remember on the last episode, she got a little deal that she'd get this business, this daycare, as long as she still played nice, like everything is all good in the hood when they represent Tate, right? So she tells the divorce lawyer that she wants to put things on hold. Just then, she's in a new daycare. Nothing is set up just yet. This guy walks in. He said his name is Quentin, but he goes by Q. Said he's looking for a daycare for his four-year-old daughter. He works constructions during the day, and so he needs somewhere for her to be during the day or whatever, right? Now, mind you, she ain't got no advertising up for it, no billboards up or nothing, but he just knew that that was a daycare that he could walk into. I don't trust this dude. Nope. I don't trust him. Tasha tells him, look here, we not open just yet, as you can see, like, I ain't got nothing in place, but how about you go on ahead and write down your number and I can call you when we get everything straight. Now, he was a little cute, little tenderoni or whatever. I give him that, you know, a little chocolate something. He was cute, but still, I don't trust the way he came up in there. She have no advertising, no billboards up, no nothing in on the white pages, on Facebook or nothing. How you know it was a daycare right there? I don't get that. Next thing you know, Tasha ends up getting a call from the bank. The bank says, I need you to come in and re-sign some papers since you're not going by St. Patrick's anymore. I need you to come in and re-sign the papers that you used to dissolve your daughter's trust fund. Tasha like, oh, what the hell? When was this? When did I do this? Oh, well, your husband bought the paperwork in. He said you signed at home. She was like, this old sneaky mofo doggone ghost. Ghost is, ooh, ghost ass. Now, y'all, Tasha pissed. She goes over there to the campaign headquarters for Tate because she's trying to let Tate know what kind of dude you got working for you, James St. Patrick, who's just going to go behind his wife's back and exhaust all of his daughter's trust fund money for what the hell, I don't know. But Tate not there. Ramona is there. And so Ramona basically tells Tasha, like, if I were you, I wouldn't worry about James. You just need to concentrate on yourself, whoop-de-whoop. Tasha broke her ass down, let her know, look here, boo-boo, I know you went through what you went through with your husband and that cheating scandal and all of that. But homegirl, you ain't got no kids. This right here is totally different. I opened up a daycare so I don't have to worry about my husband. What I need for you to do is fall back, speak when spoken to, and know that I'm trying to do this so that I don't have to worry about his ass. What he did was foul, it was wrong, and I'm gonna let y'all know. But that's all right though. Don't make me play my card in this. I don't blame Tasha. I'd have been the same way, homegirl. I know you're trying to keep the peace and all of that, but don't make me play my card in this. You don't know half the crap that this fool done put her through. Baby, ghost, girl, I need a drink on this. Ghost me with two of the Serbian goons so that they can pick up the payment to take it to Jason. Now, ghost tells one of the Serbian goons, I'm gonna need you to let your boss know that, this here's finna stop. I'm not finna keep paying him. Serbian dude gonna get up in Ghost's face and was like, oh, you gonna pay or you gonna die? Ghost said, if I die, you ain't gonna get paid worth a damn. They both in each other's face trying to see who nuts is the biggest. Then the other Serbian goon in the back was like, don't worry about this black asshole. We got to go worry about the Irish asshole and the shipment that we got coming in tonight. So the other goon kind of backed off and Ghost's ears kind of perked up when he heard him say that. He was like, oh, word? Oh, so they talking about Tommy. Ghost meets up with Tate. He tells Tate that he needs him to pull in a favor for him. He wants him to shut down an entire city block, but he doesn't say for what. Tate is like, look here, don't be out here doing no hood shit that's gonna end up coming back on me, because I ain't with that, Ghost is like, don't worry about it, I got you. I just need you to do this little small favor for me, right? Now, when Ghost leaves out, Tate ends up texting that old school dude, Will, and tells Will to keep an eye out on Ghost because he knows his ass is up to something. Y'all, so Tyreek is back at school. He get a text message from Vincent. Now, Vincent is one of the connects that deals with Tommy and Ghost. He gets a text message from Vincent that says delivery time. Reek looking like, oh hell, he don't know what to do. Next thing you know, we see this fool Tyreek is breaking into Tommy's stash house to get some pills. Boy, my heart was beating like a motherfucker. Boy, my heart was beating. He ends up getting like about 4 or 5 big bottles of pills. He's getting ready to get out. Grim and some of the other hood dudes of Tommy's, they end up coming in the stash house. So this fool Tyreek had to play it cool, play it quiet. Luckily, he didn't get his ass caught. I was so bitch when I was, tell you, I was scared. I just knew that they was finna catch his ass and they was finna kill his goddamn ass. But luckily for Tyreek, he ended up getting out of there without them catching his ass. Now, Tyreek, you trying to be, you doing too goddamn much out here in these streets. You gonna get your little ass killed. So Tommy meets up with the hood goons, right? They getting ready to go out because they got that shipment that's coming up, right? So they going over the plans. The plans is they all riding in separate cars. So should they get caught, everything ain't in one car. Just as they getting ready to roll out, one of the hood goons comes in and tells Tommy it's a gas leak and the whole block is closed off. Tommy like, man, what the hell? Like, what is we gonna do now? They end up getting in the ambulance and so they riding out. They turn the bell and the whistles on and the ambulances, so they getting through the street clear as day, right? Now, before they leave out, Ghost ass is lurking, waiting for them to leave. As Ghost is lurking, watching them, Will is watching Ghost. Will ends up calling Tate and tells Tate, hey, I think you need to get over here because some shit about to go down. No sooner than Tommy and his boys pull out the parking lot, they riding down the street in the ambulance. The road is clearing out for them because, of course, they're in the ambulance. So the fact that the block is shut down, it don't even faze them. They riding down the block. Next thing you know, boom, out of nowhere, Ghost is in a black SUV and he rams Tommy. Jumps out the car, starts blasting, shooting. They start shooting back. Tommy ends up backing out the ambulance, getting away. As he's getting away, he sees that it's Ghost. He's like, to hell with you, Ghost. Next thing you know, Ghost hops in the car because he's going to get ready to go and chase after Tommy. But the SUV is wrecked up too bad. Then two police officers end up pulling up, guns drawn, tell him to get out the car. I'm thinking, okay, that they done caught this fool, Ghost, he finna go to goddamn jail. Lo and behold, the laws end up taking Ghost back to his own office. Tate is there. tape was like, I knew you was gonna do something stupid, so I had a beat out on you. I had folks watching you because look here, I'm running for governor and ain't a damn thing you gonna do to stop that. Now Ghost lets him know, the guy that I was after is dangerous as hell. He could have ruined shit for me, you, and everybody. So the next time I'm trying to do something, I need you to stay out my damn way. Y'all, so Tasha's at her daycare. Q brings his sneaky ass in. I don't trust Q for nothing. I really don't. I'm sorry, but I don't. They end up going back in her office. He says that he wants to take her out for drinks. She's like, no, but I got some wine in my desk. So she takes out the wine. They have a cup of drinks. They shooting the shit. Child, next thing you know, they start kissing. They damn near start goosing. I'm like, damn, Tasha, get you some, girl. But then she stops or whatever. He says that he wants to take her out on a real date. And so I'm like, Tasha, go get you some, girl. I don't trust his ass, but he cute as hell, girl. But I'm just saying, I don't trust his ass, though, girl. But you don't see him. Ghost and Proctor meet up. They're sitting outside. They're in the van. Now, meanwhile, Dre has a wire on. He's inside with Sax, and he's having dinner. So, well, not dinner. Like, they're meeting up for drinks or whatever, right? And so, Sax is basically trying to get some information out of Dre. Dre is wearing a wire. Dre tells Sax that he thinks that Ghost is legit. He doesn't see Ghost doing anything, that everything seems like it's good and dandy with him. Now, meanwhile, Proctor told Dre to tell Sax that he thinks that Ghost is gonna pay off the witness to leave. He's doing that just so that he can sort of keep Dre in his pocket to kind of like basically, I trust you, but I don't trust you. I want you to throw out this little bit of information just so I can see if I can trust your ass. Now, mind you, they checked it out with the FBI. The FBI does actually have Dre's daughter. But Ghost also knows that Dre is sneaky as hell. So Dre's gonna do what he gotta do when it comes down to him and his daughter. He could give a damn less about what the hell Ghost got going on and about his he don't give a damn about Ghost. So after Dre tells Sax that he thinks that Ghost is gonna pay off this witness, later on we see that Sax ends up going to Maria's house. And Dre actually follows Sax to Maria's house. Dre ends up texting Proctor and telling Proctor that he has the address to who the witness is. Now, this fool Dre is playing both ends. He acts like he's cool with Ghost and with Proctor, and at the same time, he acting like he helping out Sax at the same time. Dre got to go, y'all. I'm telling y'all, Dre ass gotta go. I don't trust this fool. I don't trust his ass for nothing. Now, later on, Jason comes to see Ghost at his club. Ghost is talking with Jason. Dre is over it lurking, ear hustling and shit. Ghost tells Jason, like, look here, I'm not gonna keep paying you. I'm not gonna be doing none of this. Woof de woo. They have a little conversation, whatever, right? Jason just basically lets him know, you gonna do whatever the hell I tell you you're gonna do. To the period. Later on, we see Ghost goes in his office. He goes in the safe, he gets his gun, he gets this envelope, and he tells Dre to come with me. Dre ends up texting Sax, and it's like, Ghost has a gun, and he's on the move. They end up going over to Maria's house. Now, how they end up getting inside Maria's house, Dre acts like he's a maintenance guy knocking on the door. He says something to Maria. Maria ends up opening the door. They end up getting in the apartment that way. Now, Maria seemed like she about to shit on herself. Soon as she sees Ghost, she like, oh, hell no. I thought the same thing. I thought Ghost finna kill her ass. But Ghost ends up giving her an envelope full of money, telling her, I'm sorry I took somebody away from you. I want to give you another opportunity. This is the money. You can stay here. You can go off. You can live a new life, whatever you want to do, right? Now, at this same time, Dre is texting Sax, and it's like Ghost is at the witness's apartment. Sax ends up texting Dre back. It's like, all right, FBI is on the way. Keep him there, thinking that Ghost is going to kill Maria. After Ghost gives Maria this money, Ghost turns around and walks out the apartment. He didn't kill a girl. Then Dre has to end up texting Sax back and was like, no kill, hold off, stay right there. They get in the car to leave. They make it out no sooner than FBI is pulling in. Made it out just in time. See, now this fool Dre, while he's playing like he's cool with Dre, with Ghost and him in their face that whole time, he's texting behind Ghost's back, finna get this fool locked up. See, y'all, I'm telling y'all, Dre, hashtag Dre got to go. Later on, back at the club, Sax ends up calling Dre and's like, what the hell was that, man? You had me calling FBI and now they all looking at me like I'm wrong for a false call that you done made. He was like, man, I thought he was gonna kill her. Instead, he gave her a bunch of money. So he's like, also, he paid her off instead. That's against the law right there. So once again, Dre ass over his snitching. I don't trust Dre, man. He got to go. Later on, Tommy goes and meets up with Vincent about, you know, pushing some more weight. Now Vincent tells him that he already got a good supply. He don't need nothing else. He like, look here, you can see the shit that I'm getting. He shows it to Tommy. Tommy like, oh yeah, this some good shit. Matter of fact, this shit's so good, it's my shit. So Vincent like, hold on, what you talking about? I got this from, you know, whoop de whoop. He a homeboy of Kanan's. So Tommy figures out that it was Tyreek that he ended up getting this from. Baby, when I tell you, Tommy ends up going and confronting Tyreek. Tyreek lies and says that he got it from Kanan. Says that Kanan showed him Stash House before he died, and that's where he got it from. Because at first, Tommy was finna get in Reek's ass. But then soon as Reek said he got it from Kanan, Tommy kind of backed up on him. So Tommy was like, look here, I don't want you to get caught up in this life. I don't want you to have nothing to do with this life. So before he ends up leaving, he ends up taking that bag appeals with his ass too. He was like, you're not finna get caught up in this lifestyle. So not only did you steal that just for the shit to come and get took it away from you from Tommy in the first damn place, now you assed out. Now what you gonna do? So later on, he ends up going to meet with Vincent. Vincent tells him that your godfather Tommy stopped by here and he told me who you is. Cause see, he didn't tell him that he was Ghost's son. But like Reek says, you didn't ask me, so I didn't tell you. So Vincent has it in his head, basically, as long as he can control Tyreek, he can control Tommy and he can control Ghost. Now Reek, this ain't gonna end up good for you at all, my son. It ain't gonna end up good for you at all, but we gonna see what's gonna happen with that. Keisha and Tommy's mama, they over at the house chilling, whatever, right? Keisha's son Cash end up walking in the house. He got a busted lip. Keisha like, who the hell did that to you? He said that the neighborhood boys end up jumping him because he's not from there. He don't know nobody in the neighborhood. Keisha get pissed off. Keisha like, oh no, hell no, we finna go get these goddamn little boys. Now Tommy's mama tries to stop her because she's like, look here, don't bring no heat or nothing that can mess up Tommy's operation or any of that. Keisha stops and tells Tommy mama, like, look here, if this was Tommy at this age, what would you do? She tells her, oh, I'll go kick that goddamn ass. Exactly, and that's exactly what Keisha goes and does. Now later on, when Tommy gets back to the house, Keisha's not there, only his mom is there. Now his mama tells Tommy what happens. She basically tells him that she don't trust Keisha. She think that Keisha ain't built for this kind of life and that Keisha is gonna put her son before any of them. Which, yeah, she gonna do that. She really is. I'm sorry, I like Keisha, but Keisha gotta go too. I don't trust him. So later, Sax ends up meeting up with Proctor. He tells Proctor that he knows that he's associated with Tommy in some kind of way. Mind you, again, he got there from his ex, Lindsay. Now, Proctor is just like, what is it that you want from me? Like, what? What the hell is it? Now, Sax tries to get, which he does, he gets in Proctor's head. He's like, I know you got this little custody with your ex going on. Who do you think the judge is going to believe? Like, this ex who's got this great job, you know, at this great law firm, who has the backing of the whole force, or an attorney who's caught up in this scandal with this drug dealer, whoop-de-woo. Now, he knows that Proctor is hard, but he knows he's a weak-ass, punk-ass punk at the same doggone time. So he's messing with his head because he know he can get away on his ass like that. Tasha's at her daycare. Ghost walks in because he's pissed off. He found out that Tasha ended up getting to that money before his ass did. They going back and forth. Next thing you know, Q walks in. It's so sneaky ass, fine ass, chocolate ass dude that I don't goddamn trust, right? So Tasha, like, you know, rushes him outside. So they out there talking. Him and Ghost kind of make eye contact, like, yeah, nigga, I'm watching you. Yeah, nigga, I'm watching you too. I don't trust this nigga Q. I'm telling y'all mark auntie words, Q ass is up to something. I'm telling y'all, watch. Later on, when Tasha's at her daycare, Q ass comes back again, like he really trying to get with Tasha. Tasha lets him know, like, look here, I know you trying to make this work, but I ain't feeling you. We gonna have to stop whatever it is that we doing. Q tells her, well, regardless, I ain't going nowhere. Look here, I don't trust this nigga Q. He say he ain't going nowhere. plan? That's because he's a plan. He was put up in there some kind of way by somebody. I don't know who he working for, but I don't trust this motherfucker cute. All right, y'all, so Proctor is dropping his daughter Lisa Marie off at his ex Lindsay's house. Now, right before his ex gets there, Proctor puts some kind of note in her mailbox, right? So as soon as Lindsay gets there, she checks the mail, they go in the house, she sees that it's this letter. It's the same letter, it looks like, that Proctor put in the mailbox. Now, Lindsay opens up the letter and it says a failure to pass, meaning I guess she didn't pass her bar, something like that. Now, at the same time, Proctor ass is being messy. He's like, Lindsay, I just want to let you know that I'm proud of you and I'm glad you and I can co-parent, and I just want to let you know that I found somebody new and I'm thinking about proposing to her and I bought her this 5-carat ring. Like, what do you think about it? He did that shit on purpose, because you could see when she read that letter, she was devastated. She looked like her whole life had just flashed before her. But again, he just like digging it in, like, yeah, I'm proud of you and I met this new girl and I'm gonna propose to her and whoop-de-woo, right? Well, I see you later. Like, he drops that news on her while she's got this letter and he ends up leaving. Soon as he leaves out, baby, she starts searching through all of her purses until she finds a little baggie, just a little residue of cocaine. Starts putting it all on her gums, ends up calling her dealer and says she needs a delivery ASAP. That's all, baby, she back on that shit. Proctor did that on purpose. He knew what he was doing. Proctor did that shit on purpose. Later on, Lisa Marie ends up calling Proctor. He comes back to the house. Lindsay in there rambling, going off a million miles a minute. He can tell that she's high. He's like, baby, go upstairs, you know, whoop-de-whoop, go upstairs or whatever, right? She's telling him, like, I need you to call 911. She starts to, like, you can see she's starting to overdose, right? She says that she needs some water, call 911. He pulls out the phone like he's getting ready to call 911. He hits 911, then turns the phone off. Meanwhile, she's over here dying, overdosing. This fool gonna say out loud, I'm not gonna let you take my daughter away from me. Lindsay ends up overdosing and dying. This fool didn't call 911 the whole time. Lisa Marie's backpack with the unicorn that's recording everything is right there. Picked up everything that goddamn happened. So we already know that's gonna come back and bite Proctor in his goddamn ass. Later on that night, Tommy and Keisha are laying in the bed. Keisha tells Tommy about what happened with Cash, how she went out, how she kicked them little boys' ass, and how she got her baby backpack back. He also tells her that his mama don't think that she built for this kind of life. But Tommy says that he loves Keisha, he loves Cash, Ghost is no longer his family, and that they all he got. He says that that's what he's always wanted, was a family, and that he gonna ride for her as long as she ride for him. Later on, Ghost ass, he's still seeing Angela's goddamn ghost. She haunt his ass. She's telling him, like, you know, like, just Ghost, you know, just fucking with him, whatever, right? He's telling her, like, you know, I'm trying to do better. I'm trying to be the man that she wanted me to be. I had Maria right there in front of me, and I didn't kill her. Like, look, I'm trying to be the man that she want me to be. Angela's ghost, like, but you will. Oh, bitch, you will kill her. And the episode ends right there. Y'all, it was a lot that went on in this episode. I hope I didn't confuse y'all, because a lot of this I had to make sure I took some good-ass notes on. But hopefully, y'all got the gist of it, okay? If there was anything that I missed, please don't forget to comment down below and let me know. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And Auntie will see y'all in the next video. Peace out. What's up, y'all? Do me a favor and share the video. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you think, and hit that notification button so you will be up to date when I upload my latest videos. I holla.